Welcome to a special YouTube exclusive episode of Establish the Collection. I am Cody Main, joined as always by my co-host Gary Hartman. We're here tonight to do a special reveal of some extremely high-end cards that Gary recently got back from PSA. Gary, how's it going? Are you ready to do this thing, man?
It's good, man. It's good. Like I'm happy to have some of these cards back in my hands, back protected in the slabs. Mixed bag of results, which we'll see, you know, it coming up here. But overall, pretty solid, and you know, some good cards and relevant cards right now. So let's dive in, shall we?
Yeah, I think you mentioned you've got three or four names that you got back from PSA, and all three or four of them are of the utmost importance in the hobby right now. So yeah, like you said, without further ado, man, let's get into it. Let's see what you got.
Definitely true. So let's start with some football, and let's start with the guy that is probably facing his biggest test of his professional career right now. You know, and that is, you know, still the darling of the league and the future of the league, and that is Patrick Mahomes. So I had a couple Patrick Mahomes cards in this submission. One of maybe just my favorite cards that I own. I think I showed this when it was still raw on the podcast, but that is the Color Blast from Prism 2020. And this guy did gem mint, did get the 10. Ugh. So this is the Color Blast. These are the super short print chase card inserts from Prism. I just dropped it. You see them in different products depending on what sport it is, but football does put them in Prism. So you can see the shine of that guy, and that's the 10. And that's Mahomes. So that's just a great investment piece. If Mahomes does turn it around, turns the season around, and I want to throw it up there, you know, that's a card that in the right moments can definitely reach that five-figure mark for sure. So
Chiefs are 2-3. They just lost at home to the Bills. I don't think they're no longer favorites to win the division anymore.
No, which is crazy.
I mean, yeah. So great time to get that card back and hold on to it until Mahomes inevitably turns things around, because I'm sure he will. Just an absolute banger of a card to kick things off with.
All over him in DFS week 6, by the way.
Oh, yeah. Football team. Yeah. Run it back with Terry McLaurin. 100%. We'll get into the DraftKings. Your DraftKings week later.
My other Mahomes super short print out of Mosaic Choice, which is the same as, you know, Optic Choice and Prism Choice. So more Asia exclusive. These come out in, these are the peacock parallels. So they are super, super short printed. You can see they kind of have a peacock print on them. I love these cards.
Equally cool.
About 20 to 30 total in existence. This did 9, as most of my cards you'll see here did, but either way, super short printed card. Awesome card out of 2020. A great Prism, really, really, you know, aesthetically pleasing, if you ask me. And I just love those super short print inserts. So that's the other Mahomes in this submission here.
Good cards to kick things off with. Who's next? Yep.
So let's dive into our guy. I think the entire hobby's guy, the unanimous offensive rookie of the year last year, I believe. Maybe as we talked about last week, entering into the aforementioned Patrick Mahomes territory, and that is a couple Justin Herbert cards, and I couldn't have gotten these back at a more perfect time. So staying in Mosaic here, this is one of the first Mosaic breaks I ever did way back when. It was before Herbert was Herbert, you know, and I was buying up the Chargers because he was cheaper than his peers. And in like one of the first or second breaks I did, I hit the gold, true gold Mosaic rookie out of 10. This is 1 out of 10. And this also did 9, unfortunately, didn't 10, but still, when it's something that's so short printed like this, that doesn't bother me as much as if it was, you know, hey, just a silver Prism or something like that. So yeah, the true gold, Mosaic rookie Herbert PSA 9. So that's very exciting. I love anything gold.
Another beautiful card. And as you mentioned, yeah, you were wisely buying up Chargers in group breaks and team breaks and things like that last season. I think we're going to have plenty of opportunities to do the same thing this season with a couple of rookie quarterbacks who are underperforming. So a timely analysis there for you. And obviously, as we talked about last week, with the narrative starting to shift, honestly, as media pundits are quickly ratcheting Justin Herbert up their rankings, putting him in that Mahomes, that Josh Allen, that Kyler Murray tier, good time to get those back. What are you doing with those, big boy? What are you going to do with those cards?
I'm of two minds, and I'll show you a couple more high end ones here right now. But I think I will put some of them up at very high buy it nows, and just, you know, if he continues to, you know, just dominate this season, you know, I'll just take whatever offers come in and see if it's something worth pulling the trigger on. I did tell you before off the air, like I'm taking some of my mid tier Herbert stuff. So I'm like, this is a Spectra RPA. Very nice card out of 75, mm-hmm. things like this. I'm going to throw him up in auction to end on a Sunday that I feel like he has a good matchup and just see what it does. Because I'm not too worried about the end price on something like that, but I do think I'm maximizing profits on that mid-tier stuff right about now. So that's where I'm at with Herbert, because I'm comfortable keeping some of that stuff long-term. I do believe in the talent that much. Stuff like this. So this is the green prism I showed also on the podcast, the green select prism, I should say. This is the club level. It's a pretty short printed one. This is 5 out of 5 equals his jersey number 10. People always love that. This is a true green out of 5. Very, very short printed. This is the kind of piece that I feel comfortable holding on to long term. The only thing better than this in this tier of select is the black 1 of 1. So, something that I feel great about. Again, also 9 here. May have had a little bit of a tough grader on that submission. That was part of the express tier. It seems that they were liking the 9s for me this go around. And I've talked about this before on the grading episodes. I'm super careful with how I examine and clean these cards. I thought that a lot of these should have 10'd when I sent them in. Clearly, a grader saw something different. It's okay. At least they didn't 8, 7 or 8. But sticking with Herbert, this is more of a classic. This is his Silver Prism autograph. A fantastic card that definitely a chase card for many people. And I have – this is actually my only Silver Prism of Herbert. So I don't even have a regular Silver Prism, just have the autograph. I do have a ton of base Prism that I would be looking to send in at some point. But, again, another 9 here, a little bit of a theme with these football cards. But very happy with this card and just having this one in my collection. Another one that whether I sell it during the season right now to maximize profits or I hold on to, I'm very comfortable with a card like that.
I wanted to stop you there for a second because as has become customary on the podcast and on the YouTube shows, we're doing these right as a Dibs drop is about to happen. And so tomorrow, Dibs is dropping 3 of those Justin Herbert autographs integrated in PSA 10.
Yeah, yeah.
So those exact cards, except for PSA 10.
Except now, a little bit better.
And they're offering another discount as we continue to talk about. So if for some reason you guys are listening to this and those drops have not yet filled, I'm sure they will go quickly based off of how Herbert's performed and based off the price that they're dropping at. But again, check out the Dibs platform. We're going to talk much more in depth on Dibs with our NBA buys coming up in a future episode. But just be mindful of those things. You can take advantage of some discounts. And Gary's got a 9 there, which is an absolute sweet card. Dibs is dropping a few 10s tomorrow. And it's just, take advantage of these opportunities where you can find things at slight discounts.
Absolutely, for sure. And that's a card that I would consider doing something with that I'm about to talk about with this card. From one MVP to another, one MVP candidate to another, Kyler Murray, also a card that I showed recently on the podcast. This is his first off the line contenders rookie ticket autograph. So you see how it's the red foil, the red zone, they call it. It's basically the same as his team logo, first contenders rookie ticket. But just with this special first off the line exclusive, mm-hmm. So slightly more short printed. Also 9. This was the biggest surprise to me. I really looked at this one. You can take a look at it front and back. I don't see much wrong with this card. Clearly, maybe there's something that they see a little bit with the centering. I'm not entirely sure. But I thought for sure this one would 10. This was the biggest surprise for me. I'm very strongly considering this crossing over to BGS because I am quite certain that this would 9.5 over there. And I think I'd prefer to get the gem mint. I was looking a little bit on eBay comps before. I think this card right now in the 9 would probably be like between $1,300 and $1,500. But if I were able to get it over to that BGS 9.5, I think we're talking a couple grand more for that. And I've talked about how I like having autographed cards in BGS slabs anyway. So that's one, along with the Herbert, if I examine that a little bit further, that I would consider crossing over to see if I can get that 9 to jump up to a gem. At that point, you wasted $150 sending to PSA, but right. It is what it is when you're dealing with cards that are high end like that. So that's all the football stuff I got. Shall we transition to a little hoops?
Yeah, let's do it. Because that will be the feature of an upcoming episode for Established Run. Gary and I are going to do an underdog draft live. We'll see how things go. They've gotten very hectic when we've done the NFL draft in the past. So we'll see how things go. Check out episode 24 of Established Collection on Apple iTunes. It'll be posted to YouTube later. But yeah, let's get into some hoops, man, because definitely. I'm excited for the NBA season.
Only a couple more cards here, but the two that I did submit were Zion Williamson. Obviously, someone that... when I did send these, by the way, the injury news wasn't fully out yet that he's dealing with a foot problem, and hopefully it won't derail his entire season or too much of it, but still completely bullish on him long-term. Not too concerned there yet, knock on wood. This is probably the highest value card of my entire submission because it was my only other 10, and that is the Zion Williamson Downtown Panini 101. Just such a sweet card. The other short print chase cards from 1 and 1 also hit this in a break, actually. And, this is like... there's actually not that much data on it, on even card letter right now, because people are not selling these cards so often, the tens, but the last one I think went for 12.2K. And you know, just something that is, the downtowns are just one of the sweetest inserts. They basically take the culture and the theme of the city that the player plays in and like puts a cool art piece around it. And yeah, so this card, Gem Mint 10, out of 1-1, which was a new product last year, which I think was a big hit, and I'm sure they'll bring it back this year, and that 10. So love that card. Really excited to have it. Will definitely be a hold for me right now as the Zion situation kind of, you know, shakes itself out. My other Zion Williamson card was, these are my overall favorite inserts in all of basketball cards. That is the Dragon Scale inserts out of Optic Choice Asia. So these are Asian exclusive, the Donruss Optic Choice. Super short printed Dragon. So like the green foil parallel with kind of has that Dragon Scale on there. These are very, very tough to hit. Probably about 20 made per player, 20 to 25. Also nine. I knew this would 9 or 9.5 if I sent it to BGS because it is slightly off centered, which I knew. But I knew that it was perfect otherwise. So I was anticipating a 9. I would have been upset if it got an 8. Totally happy with the 9 on this. A BGS 9 I had looked was the only other comp I could find that went for, what did we talk about before the show, Cody? Like 4.5 or 5K, yep. I believe. So PSA 9 should be at least 2X, I would say, better than that for the BGS. So a card that I'm really bullish on. I have the Ja Morant in a 10. I have the RJ Barrett in a 10 of the Dragon Scale. So I have the top three picks from that draft of their Dragon. So really, really excited about that.
Can you tell what Gary was breaking? Yeah, 2 years ago.
I probably broke the most Optic Choice from that year of any person in the world. That's
did you get those other two from a break as well?
No, the RJ I actually just bought as a single because you know he's my PC.
He's
but
your
the,
boy.
But the Morant I did get in a break. A LeBron Dragon I got in a break. A Jokic Dragon I got in a break. So I have some sick and all slabbed up, either PSA 9s or 10s. So I should maybe I'll post on the Establish a Collection Instagram as I can hoops kick off my entire Dragon collection, because
that's awesome.
I have some really fun ones. And it's such a great insert. It's so smooth looking. It's a rated rookie, and it's those are just awesome.
Yeah, those are very, very, very cool looking cards.
It would not be a PSA reveal, a modern Gary PSA reveal, without my favorite sport. Without the leader in the clubhouse for the championship of the season with about 6 races remaining, and that is Max Verstappen. This is his orange sapphire variation. So the variation, we've talked about this in the past, is them sitting down as opposed to standing up. That is the short print. And it says on the label, it's a short print. Guys, this is a PSA 7. And we talked about this with these cards. They are very, very tough grades. I knew this would probably get no better than an 8. I was hoping for an 8. An 8 and a 7 is an acceptable grade for this. If it's below that, you have a decision to make as far as if you want to sell something raw or better. If it's above an 8, you're sitting so pretty because you're getting a premium on these cards. They're just, for whatever reason, the way Topps produce these, there's dings on the edges a lot of surface issues. So for whatever reason, it's just an acceptable thing. These are going to be 7s or 8 very often. A 7 of this exact same card sold for $4,000 recently. I think if he wins the championship and Red Bull wins the constructors, if they're able to do that, this card goes up. He's the future of the sport. Totally fine holding this long term. And it's out of 25. So this is 2 out of 25 for the Max Verstappen short printed orange parallel. So that's my little PSA reveal. Only, you know, 8 or 9 cards or whatever, but there was Express and Super Express. Basically had to decide when I wanted to really pony up the cash to get some high-end stuff in there, because again, the cheapest thing right now is $150 Express tier. So you have to be careful. And for full transparency, that Mahomes Prism Color Blast and the Zion Downtown 1-1 I did at Super Express. It's a $300 tier. I got pushed back. They upcharged me. Once those things tend, they out threshold the $10,000 of value. And they basically said, no, you're screwed. Like, we're charging you $450 per card or whatever. I got to go through the walkthrough tier for those. So, you know, it's expensive, but when you're talking about cards like this, you have to kind of pony up to get your full premium back, which you need for PSA when you're talking about cards like that, especially if they have the chance of 10, you almost have to get them in that PSA slab at that point.
Right. This was a fun reveal, man. I'm very excited for you. I know you're a little disappointed with some of the 9s that you got. Okay. Very, very, very exciting to get started getting things back from PSA. We'll be able to talk more about your experience with PSA and the entire process more on an upcoming episode. If you guys are new here, obviously subscribe to the YouTube channel, hop over to Apple iTunes, find our podcast, subscribe, rate, review the podcast. We're doing a lot of interesting content over there, trying to get you guys geared up for all of the great happenings in the hobby with all the sports, as Gary mentioned, F1 and NBA and NFL. And I'm big on UFC, so we'll have plenty to talk about in the upcoming weeks. We appreciate you guys checking out the quick PSA reveal. Gary's, you know, slight $50,000 mail day from PSA. You can't ever argue with that, man.
No, not at all.
For Gary, I'm Cody. We'll see you next time.
Thanks for checking us out, guys.